Hey guys, Andy here from Service Your Body. So today for Keeping You Moving Monday, it's foam rolling Mondays. So I'm just going to show you a few techniques on how to foam roll the lower part of your body. Okay, so you can use a nice long foam roller. This was once about a meter long, just chopped it in half. Some people use the foam rollers that are hollow with the little trigger point divots on it. I don't think there's much of a difference personally. When you're rolling, you're looking at rolling about 10 or 5 to 10 times along a muscle group. And when you find a little knot, you kind of pulse over and back along that area until you feel it's freeing out. It's sore to do, but the more you do it, the easier it gets, and obviously the more beneficial it is. So first and foremost, we're going to kneel on the foam roller to get our shins. So if you're a runner and you do a lot of mountain running or hill running, you may find your shins get quite tight. So this is a beauty for those. So we're going to come into this position here, and we're just going to roll forwards and backwards. Now we're kind of just rolling on our shin bone here. So if we turn out to the side, so if I roll out to the side of my right leg, I've come off the bone and now I'm on my anterior tibialis, or the muscle going up the front of my shin. And I'm just going to rock in and out of that one. And then I'm going to turn and I'm going to put my body weight and twist my left leg, so I'm rolling out along that shin there. And again, if you find somewhere tender, stay on it and pulse. Not very nice, but quite effective. Okay, then we're going to get we all love to roll our IT bands. Doesn't make a huge difference to roll your IT band, but it's worthwhile because there's a couple of muscle structures in and around the IT band. So the best thing to do is to start maybe at the top of the hip and work down halfway along the muscle. So we're just working halfway into that muscle. You can use this leg for support, this arm for support. And then you're going to start at the bottom of the IT band and work from the bottom of the muscle halfway up. So at least, you know, it's easier to control. You can do the full range stuff if you want. You can take your two legs off and work through that. It's a little bit sorer. You can roll around to the front of the quad a little bit, so you're getting where the IT band meets the front of the quad. You can roll around the back to get where the hamstring kind of joins the IT band. Very nice to do. Again, 5 to 10 strokes and stop on something tight. Then you come above your hip bone, but below the crest of your pelvis. And we're just going to sit in that pocket and we're going to work in there. Much more beneficial tackling this part of the area than getting your IT band, because all the tightness in the IT band comes from up around the top of the hip and the glute. Then you're going to aim for your glute. We sit on the roller on the side you want to work. You get that foot, cross it over the opposite knee. We've opened up that hip joint and we sit into that glute. Again, not very pleasant. It has to be done. So we're just dropping in, really working through, and kind of twist and turn over, so you're getting different parts, different glutes, different muscle groups into the piriformis, all those external rotators. Good stuff. And really working into it, okay? Excellent. Then we're gonna hop onto our belly. We get the front quad nice and easy. Two quads at the same time, rolling in and out, nice and comfortable on the elbows. And we're just working the top half of the muscle. Again, I can turn out to get the outside of the top half, just rotate off the center. And then turn it to the inside a little bit to get the other side, okay? And again, you work the lower part of the muscle. Start at the top of the knee, work up. Halfway, 5 to 10 strokes. Turn out, nasty, ooh, very sore there. And then on to the other one, and get that one. Calves are a different story. A couple of ways to try those. Difficult enough, prop yourself up on your elbows. Cross one leg over, boom off, and you rock up and down. Again, working the lower half of the muscle. And then move it up to the top half of the muscle. Work the top. You can turn your feet out a little bit sore. Hit those tender points. Ouch, ouch, ouch. Then, lovely for the back. Sitting on your roller, cross your arms, out and back. Working the lower half of the back. Carry on strangling yourself with your hood. And then work all the way up into the back. Very nice. You can turn to the side to get all the way along just the outside of the spine. And now we can mobilize our back. Sit with your bum on the floor. arms crossed. I'm just going to extend through the spine, move the roller up a couple of vertebrae, extend again. You can twist and turn to open up those thoracics. Roll it up, twist and turn to open up the thoracics all the way through. Very good to do. Okay, so that's just a quick demo on what you can do. You can use other hockey balls, things like that, to get into some of the hip joints if you're brave enough, if you really want it. But it's very beneficial to get in around that pocket area for IT band and glute issues. Any questions, give us a shout. Thank you.